Hello everybody. Today I am going to talk about a group paper published in February 2021, Antiferromagnetic Half-Skirmions and Bimerons at Room Temperature. Currently, we are using CMOS technology complementary metal oxide semiconductor devices and to improve efficiency and performance, we are changing the way towards topologically protected ferromagnetic hills, which are promising. One example is skirmions and their antiparticles. Applications are such as solitonic information carriers in racetrack memory in logic or neuromorphic devices. Soliton, I search, it is a self-reinforcing pulse or traveling wave caused by any nonlinear effect. Also neuromorphic, describing any very large scale system of integrated circuits. What does inhibit the ferromagnetic practical implementation? Two answers are presence of dipolar fields in ferromagnetic materials and also the deleterious skirmion Hall effect. Why we are interested in antiferromagnets? Relativistic dynamics, fast deflection-free motion, and size scaling, which they need to be experimentally demonstrated. In this work, the authors realized a family of topological antiferromagnetic spin textures in hematite, which is an earth-abundant oxide insulator. The novelty of this work is stabilizing exotic merons and antimerons, which are called half-skirmions, and also the pairs of merons and antimerons, which are called bimerons. How they use the first order analog of the Kibel-Zurek mechanism. Half-skirmions and bimerons also can be erased by magnetic field, and they said that regeneration can be happened by temperature cycling, cooling and heating. About KZM or Kibel-Zurek mechanism, Tom W.B. Kibel, which is died unfortunately, and Zurek, the young man, they described the non-equilibrium dynamics and the formation of topological defects in a system which is driven through a continuous phase transition at a finite rate. About half-skirmions, we have a formula for planar skirmions. And as you can see here, Q is explained by this formula. Q is topological charge of the magnetic structure. If Q is integer, we call it skirmion. If it is half integer, we call it half skirmion. It can be positive or negative. What about bimerons? Bimerons, a magnetic bimeron is a pair of two merons. The impellent magnetized version of skirmions is considered as bimeron. They have some similarities. What they prepared was in the order of 100 nanometers in size, and the samples were controllable by manipulating exchange stiffness and anisotropy. They use a heavy metal over layer which causes current-based spin torques. So we will have low energy antiferromagnetic spin torques concept at room temperature. We observe a stray field in topological textures of antiferromagnetic materials. Also, we have compensated the ferromagnetic sublattices, but L or nil vector L, which is assumed as the order parameter of antiferromagnetism, twists in these textures. It generates a non-zero nil topological charge, which is called Q. About antiferromagnetism, we named some properties which give a topological protection to the antiferromagnetic textures. Also, it decreases the limitations we have in ferromagnetic materials. Also, insulating antiferromagnetics, it halts the ultra-fast spin dynamics, which is very interesting, and the relativistic motion of textures, which can be due to low Gilbert damping or the exchange amplification effect in the spin torrents. The third reason is antiferromagnetic insulators are important candidates for low power spin torrents, which is desirable because of negligible joule losses. The idea in the paper is generating and controlling antiferromagnetic textures in insulators, which they are crucial for fundamental understanding of the proposed structures, and also talking and discussing the applications. The literature says like this: experimental observation in metal-based synthetic AFM stacks is clear for us, but we need to go deep into natural antiferromagnetic materials. These authors have another work which they explain shortly. They said that we showed that insulating antiferromagnetic oxide hematite like this, also they use a ferromagnetic overlayer, which in that work was cobalt, which supports flat vortices and anti-vortices in AFM layer. But they explained about spin orbit torques and what happened in this work. But now what they want to do? Now they are trying to investigate different antiferromagnetic topological textures, including some analogies of spin muons. They are using hematite and platinum overlayer, felt-free and reversible stabilization or stabilization of these antiferromagnetic textures. They change temperature to see what will happen. The nucleation happened below and at room temperature, and they use a simple chemical tuning. Because of short of time, I have to go faster. Hematite has a trigonal corundum structure. Space group is R minus 3 or 3 bar C. Also, about the spin orientation they discuss in this paper, also they explained shortly about Morin transition temperature, or TM. We will discuss about TM or Morin temperature so much in the next slides. More in transition or spin flop transition. It is a magnetic phase transition in hematite. Below TM, anticoromagnetic ordering changes. To be aligned parallel to the C axis in the crystal. For Bach hematite, TM or Morin temperature is 260 Kelvin. Also, if the particle size decreases, it will reduce again. We have a concept nil vector L equals to M1 minus M2 like this. It lies in plane or IP. From now on, I will say IP and OOP for in plane and out of plane concepts. In plane for above TM and out of plane for OOP for below TM. The thin film samples they prepared were epitaxially grown on 0001 oriented substrates, which was aluminum oxide. They used pulse laser deposition and they found Morin transition or TM 240 approximately Kelvin. And for RH substituted films, it was 298 Kelvin increase. Also, for crystals, sometimes we have HKIL instead of HKL. It is Miller-Verovai indexing, which I equals to minus H plus K. PEEM technique or photoemission electron microscopy. For this thing, they use 1 nanometer platinum overlayer. And platinum is good because it doesn't change the magnetic properties of the films. Also, it is suitable for spintronic applications because of spin orbit coupling is very large. Another technique, XMLD technique or X-ray magnetic linear decorism. This technique confirmed the L orientation across the respective Morin temperature. L means we discussed about that vector, and we will see it is parallel or anti-parallel. I want to go a little faster to the results. Because of that, I go to the next slide. About the XMLD plus PEM experiment, they measured by considering temperature change, and they mapped the spatial distribution of antiferromagnetic textures. Because of this formula in this technique, we have delta equals to the equation we are seeing here. For in-plane and out-of-plane, we will have different values of delta. And we call them LV and LH, vertical and horizontal linear polarization of X-ray. Because the delta values are different, we can find information about IP and OOP. By using the technique we discussed here, they could also combine horizontal images, and they have about 6 angles, and they found interesting figures. We will see them in the next slide. They say that we can determine topological character of most spin textures through W, nil binding, Q, nil topological charges. The sign of Q or nil topological charge cannot be determined by XMLD. They need a reference layer to study about this sign. As you can see in the picture, we will magnify then in the next slide, evolution across the Murin transition. About the Murin transition, as you can see in the picture, we have different temperatures. For the sample, first sample was only hematite without pelagic. Yellow color means IP, and the purple means OOP or out of plane. The first figure B, as you can see here, it is for temperatures less than Murin temperature. And mostly you see OOP or out of plane spins. And here the purple parts are separated by AFM or anti-ferromagnetic antiphase domain walls. From now on, its name, we will call them ADW, which are in yellow boundaries shape. Also, we have some reverse or time reverse domains in yellow parts by 180 degrees, like OOP, IP, and again OOP. When we warm up to about Murin temperature, we observe that out of plane on isotropy or purple parts are being weakened, and then IP parts are increasing, as you can see, for example, here, and yellow parts are widening. Nucleation of a small IP or interlinked island. Here, as you can see, some new points are emerging. Also, for higher temperature, they will widen again. By increasing the temperature more than or greater than Murin temperature, interlinked domains dramatically enlarge, and they will be the matrix, means they will be the larger matrix, yellow regions. And as you can see, the purple or out of plane parts will be like islands, and they persist after room temperature. In this picture, about picture A, you see a temperature dependent moment and measurement, and it is happening across the TM or Murin temperature, and we have a small hysteresis. The overall evolution of antiferromagnetic textures can be reversed. Reversion is very important by cooling the sample across TM. Also, similarly for PT covered or layered hematite thinking will also be in the interface. What we see here is somehow similar to the previous pictures, and the results will be discussed in the next slide. They use a technique or images which are called XMCDPEM, which is sensitive to weak antiferromagnetic about TM. And also, they say that the features in figure 1B and L we saw them before, they were purely because of antiferromagnetism origin. Now we will go to the figures from this technique. First, they put a title, Merons, Antimerons, and Bimerons. Then They said that we have in the pictures nail vector maps of in-plane orientations of L labeled using a red, green, blue, or RGB color scale, as you can see in the pictures, 180 degrees periodicity, and out-of-plane orientations are white. For low temperature, you can see they are white, but they are being smaller when temperature is increased. At low temperature, what we see, most regions are out of plane oriented. But you see here again, antiphase domain walls, narrow lines, and we have mixed black and nil type domain walls regions. For example, the black ones are black type and yellow ones are nil type domain regions. I go faster, and for temperature, about morning temperature, as you can see in the picture, out of plane regions or white parts are shrinking. Antiphase domain walls and in-plane islands widen. Sometimes they are merging with each other. For high temperature, higher than, greater than morning temperature, they observe the complex antiferromagnetic textures. And here is very beautiful story. S-fins are predominantly lying in the basal planes, and the in-plane phenomenon is happening, and S-fins are separated by 60 degrees domain walls. Also here, they announced that the out-of-plane bubbles, they don't disappear completely, but they shrink. And we have two types of six-fold pins, wheels, and which they are vortices and anti-vortices, but W is not zero. LV, meaning vertical linear, and mixed with PEM image. This images, as you can see in figure two, figures C and D. What is happening? We want to compare these two pictures. First one is LV PEM, and the second one, first one is the vector map, and second one is LVPEM, this picture number D. And as you can see here, there is a similarity in the points. The points you can see in figure C, taken by LVPEM, by vector map images, and here, in D, you can see same small points or islands of out of plane. In the next slide, we discuss shortly about the magnetic evolution that is investigated as a function of temperature. They put an analogy between this model and Kibel Zurek transition model. They say that they are similar, but there are some differences. Firstly, in their system, in this paper, discrete rather than continuous symmetry is present. And also, they say that based on anisotropy, U1 symmetry, it is a symmetry in crystallography, and it is weak. Second item is that Morin transition is first order, and formation of antiferromagnetic topological textures is governed by nucleation, not by fluctuations. The third difference is that here they are discussing what topologically trivial phase is ordered. And because of this topologically trivial phase, we will see different types of dimensional spin textures. Reversibility is another concept in this paper. Merons and antimerons can be destroyed by, as you can see here, cooling and using magnetic field, and also regeneration will be happened by rewarming around the molten temperature, which they called it thermal cycle, which is cooling and heating process. Most topological textures appear at a completely new position. It means that it is regeneration and recreation is happening, but not in the same positions. In figure 2C, nail vectors again, what was observed? Two types of basic topology, nail type and block type. And they relate these points to, as you can see in this figure, nail antiferromagnetic meron and block antiferromagnetic meron. Also, in addition to merons, and also as you can see in the top picture, antiferromagnetic antimeron, they are seeing that some pairs are observed, numerous antiferromagnetic meron antimeron pairs. In this case, as you can see here, topological charge totally is an integer. It can be Q equals to plus or minus one. In this case, we call it bimeron. Bimeron is a quasi particle, and it is somehow equivalent to a skelmion. So here we have Q equals equals to one. But in the next slide, we discuss that if meron and antimeron, they have opposite sign, total Q will be zero. In this case, for Q equals to zero, we call it topologically trivial meron pair or TTMP. I go back here again, Q equals to plus or minus one by meron, Q equals to zero, TTMP. We will compare by meron and TTMP. TTMPs, they do not have enough topological protection, and they form a metastable bound state. Total winding number away from cores is zero for both by meron and TTMPs. We cannot determine the total topological charge of meron pairs. Antimerons, about antimerons, two things can happen. Annihilation, or they come closer to each other and will be stable. The former, I mean annihilation, it can be TTMPs, which Q was zero. And the second item can be bimeron with Q equals to one. Interestingly, they found that their merons and antimerons, they are long lasting. And as you can see here, they found that lifetime of the antiferromagnetic merons is several orders of magnitude longer than predicted for antiferromagnetic steel moons. So the stability of neurons and antineurons is very interesting. About the control of the texture dimensions, they say that feature sizes of the antiferromagnetic textures is temperature dependent, and it can be controlled by two concepts: exchange stiffness AX and also anisotropy K, which is diverged when anisotropy is very close to zero. They use an ansatz, and they assume that antiferromagnetic 8dW and also neuron and antineurons, both of them are linear. They propose two formulas, W and D. And as you can see in the formula, A, X, and K, X and stiffness and anisotropy are included in the formula, and they are ADW width and neuron antineuron cores. They say that this formula, they are not irrespective if there is no interfacial DMI. There must be interfacial DMI for the Zeal-Lechinsky Moreley interaction. And but it is in good agreement with experimental data from the PEEM or photon emission electron microscopy for both samples they prepared. In this picture, as you can see, the lines are modeled and the average circles and squares are experimental with good agreement. Near morning temperature, both W and D from the formula diverge as anisotropy is equal to zero approximately. But away from morning temperature, the magnitude of anisotropy increases both for W and D. When anisotropy is increases, W and D will decrease. Good result is that it is possible to tune the room temperature size of neuron and antineuron cores by reducing exchange stiffness or increasing anisotropy. Additionally, here they say that a minimal intra-bimeron core-core distance also it can be controllable. They can manipulate meron core sizes by chemical doping or additional anisotropy induced by an overlayer for practical applications. The last part is annihilation of topological textures. The effect here is imperimagnetic felts, which is or are applied ex situ. We have some images from LVPM technique. The first item, picture A, is original state, means we have zero felt state at room temperature. In this state, you see several purple dots. Neuron antineuron number density is about 0.45 micrometer squared minus, and I refer to 0.45 here. In the second one, it is 50 millitesla applied ex situ field, which is impelling, and the value decreased And when they go to figure C, 500 millitesla, they found a larger scale annihilation. And as you can see here, N is 0.01. But if I go back, N was 0.45, from 45 to 1. But what will happen in figure D? We are using cooling and warming procedure. First, we say that field or magnetic field erasability may result from movement of the impelling domains under the influence of Zeeman coupling between field and M. And after we have the erasure here, regeneration is happening by thermally cycling across marine temperature. And again, the value of N is 0.43 approximately, close to the original value here, 0.45. 0.45 come to 0.01 again, 0.43, it is very close to each other. The antiferromagnetic topological textures are regenerated through the sample. It means that large area measurements confirm this. And also in the pictures, they are clear. The result is that we have a phenomenon. It is similar to or analogous to Kibel-Zurek model, and it is down across marine temperature. It can be used as a reversible mechanism for annihilation plus regeneration or recreation of antiferromagnetic meron, antimerons, and bimerons. At the end, they proposed one important prospect. It is using platinum layer. Currents in platinum layer, it can result in spin accumulation due to spin Hall effect. It can drive